Good morning. In the previous unit, we made an attempt to understand what is commodity, what is commodity market, and also the various players and their motives in the commodity market. Now, we will try to understand what is commodity exchange, what is the role of commodity exchange in promoting the interest of the farmers, and how it is regulated, and what are different types of commodity exchanges operating in India. First, we will try to understand commodity exchange. And the term indicates it has two concepts. One is commodity, second is exchange. Commodity exchange is a place where commodities are sold and brought under regulated market conditions. So, a commodity market performs three valuable functions. First one is it brings buyers and sellers on a common platform, make them to interact with each other. Second is it provides information to the both buyers and consumers on a daily basis. If you see the economics newspaper or a business line, every day morning they publish the price of the commodity market traded in the previous day. So, this gives an updated market information to the both the parties, buyers and sellers. And most important role played by commodity exchange today is it try to settle the dispute between buyer and seller. Always when the goods are traded in a large scale, especially the high value product, there will be dispute between buyer and seller. Commodity exchange settle the dispute between buyer and a seller. These are the three important functions performed by commodity exchange. Commodity exchange is becoming very, very important because commodities can be sold in the spot market across the counter, or it can be sold in the future market. To mitigate the risk and to invent the new price for the product, most of the commodities are sold in the future market. In the future market, the new tool invented is derivatives. Meaning of derivatives. Derivatives is a security whose value system is derived from the value of other asset. The value from which the derivatives values are derived is called underlying asset, and each derivative contract has underlying asset. Derivative tools are used to hedge the risk that arises during a course of buying and selling. It is very, very useful for agriculture because tomato today sold at 50 rupees per kg. A rainy season, you start cultivating, crop comes after 4 months, the price may come down 20 rupees. So, what happens? You will incur a huge amount of loss. You will never know what is the return coming out of this. You are always tense, and you are always, bank will not give a loan to you. And if you took loan from the bank for the cultivation of tomatoes, if the rate comes down 20 rupees, you will not able to pay the price. So, all farmers want to cover this risk by entering into a future market. We will try to understand what are the various methods of future market. Derivative markets, there are 4 types, but popular 3 types: forward market, future market. Forward contract, as I explained in the previous slide, it is an agreement wherein you agreed. A forward contract is an agreement to buy or sell an asset on a specified price on a specified future date. Here, 3 things are pre-decided: price, quantity, quality, and time. See, you say in December, I supply 10,000 quantity of wheat at a rate of 50 rupees. So, quantity is predecided. He may also mention quality. The time is also predecided. But the payment and delivery happens in December. In June, you enter into a contract with the rice mill owner. The rice grower, cultivator can enter an agreement with the rice mill owner saying that I will supply 5,000 quantity of rice to you in December at the price of 50 rupees per kilo. It is pre-decided, but payment is made only in December, delivery also happens in the future. This is called future trading. Right now you don't have product, but you enter an agreement to sell after 6 months. This is a very, very important tool available for future market. Next is future market. Both looks similar. Here also an agreement is made between buyer and seller to sell certain amount of product in a future date at a particular price. Difference in the between this is forward contract is always happens on the across the counter. It happens between 2 parties, even private parties, whereas the future contract takes place in the a formal place called commodity exchanges. See, a cultivator can directly enter an agreement with the rice mill owner. It may be written, it may be oral. And they have to settle the dispute among themselves, whereas in a future contract, it happens in the commodity exchange. You will have a signed document, and a third party will monitor this. suppose you fail to implement this, will be an arbitrage, and you have to pay penalty for this, and they will ensure that you get the assured quantity of goods at an assured price. Whereas in a forward contract, it happens between two private individuals. Most of the cases it is not written, it is only informal agreement, but gentleman agreement. Normally they honor this agreement at a future date. This is different between forward and future. In both the cases, the transaction happens in a future date at an agreed rate in the present. So you will inventing a new price now. See, onion price today is 60 rupees per kilo. After 6 months, you don't know what is the price, if you leave it a market price, but today only enter an agreement with a buyer that I will supply certain amount of quantity at a particular date. If it happens in an organized, standardized procedure, it is called future contract. If it is happens in an informal between two individual, it becomes forward contract. Both happens in the future market. And the benefit of, what is the benefit of this future market, both in case of forward contract and future contract, is price discovery. How do you discover a price? I think I had given example of tomatoes now. Tomatoes, most of South Indian market sold at 50 rupees. You start cultivating, you get a crop after 3 months. What is the price after 3 months? If you don't trade in future market, you leave it to market for demand and supply. And because of that, you price is unknown, but here you will have a definite price. You enter an agreement with Reliance Fresh that I will supply this much of quantity of tomatoes at this much of price. It's assured. So you that price again you discuss, you both the parties will say. So looking at the climatic condition, looking at the market situation, both of them will sit together and negotiate, come to a new price. Then price risk management, same thing. Second advantage is price risk management. Farmers face two types of risk. One is price uncertainty, second is production uncertainty. And production uncertainty is most of the agricultural product depends on nature directly. Maybe very few part of the farms are cultivated through irrigation. When you directly depend on nature for cultivation, you will never know what is the quantity of production. Sometimes bumper price, sometimes you don't have any crop at all. So it's very uncertain. Second is you have a bumper price, but price you don't know. So price risk management happens in this future market. Then benefit for farmers and agriculture, because you have an assured market. Credit worthiness, very very important is credit with accessibility. So a wheat farmer says, I want one crore loan because I have a huge hectares of land. I will repay after 6 months. But what is the guarantee that he will sell at a particular price and make profit and repay? Banker says, no, I can't pay you because there's no assured return for you. But in the future market, if an enter into a future contract or a forward contract, the price is assured, the revenue is assured, the banker has no problem in giving loan to the farmers. So this future contract assures regular flow of credit to the farm. That is the main advantage of the future market, both the producer as well as the consumer. So now we will try to understand the option trade. When compared to future market and forward market, in option market you enter an agreement, but I don't execute it. I have a right to buy or sell, but an obligation to exercise that right. Example, I enter an agreement to buy 10,000 quantity of vegetables at a price of 20 rupees per quintal, future date. But on that date, I feel that price has come down, I don't buy at all. But what you can do is, you can say difference price. I agreed to buy at a 30 rupees, current price is 25, I will pay difference of 5 rupees. There is no need of buying that quantity and selling it to someone else. The option is, if the price goes up to 60 rupees, I agree at a 50, price go to 60, I will buy and sell at a 60 rupees. I have an option to exercise that option of buying or selling. It is call option, right to buy, put option, right to sell. Both the parties can exercise this, but you have to pay difference of premium. This is again hedging of risk. I agree to sell at 50 rupees to you, but market price is 60, I won't sell it to you. What should I sell? I sell only difference price of 10 rupees to you, I sell it to someone else at a much higher rate. So this is another agreement wherein both buyers and sellers can make a profit in the future market. Very very important aspect. Now the derivatives, I think I told you the meaning of the derivatives. it is sold in the, it is a product which is derived from another product and it is sold in the future market. As it is sold in the future market, lot of speculation happens. To avoid speculations, we have a regulatory system. There are two types of derivatives, financial derivatives and commodity derivatives. Financial derivatives are very volatile, stock exchange, lot of people invested money in that, they lost money also. They have a SEBI to regulate this, both future and options. Similarly, we have a Ministry of Consumer Affairs which controls forward market transactions. There is a commission called Forward Market Commission which sets up commodity exchanges, and commodities both at a national level and a regional level, these are controlled, and future transactions are controlled by Ministry of Consumer Affairs through a Forward Market Commissions. Look at the share of commodities group in the, actually this commodity market, government is hoping that lot of agriculture product will come to the market, but the share of agriculture products traded in the market is very, very less, only 12% when compared to other product. The reason is the farmers are not aware about the mechanism of the commodity exchanges because their education level is low, and they are also not accessible to the information, like they are illiterate and they can't read newspaper. They don't have an IT skill also, they cannot go to website and do this, and because of this they are not trading in the stock commodity exchanges. Now, let's have a brief look at commodity exchanges in India. We have regional and national, and important them are shown in the slides. We have National Commodity Exchange. It's a public limited company started in December 15, 2003. It is a major, they are the major player in the market. Around 70% of this trading happens in this exchange, and currently it facilitates trading of 57 commodities made in agro product. Next, multi commodity exchange, also another leading, these two commodity exchanges together controls around 90% of the trading in India. It head office in Mumbai and is a well known for bullion and metal trading platform. Then we have Indian Commodity Exchange. This is also started in 2009, its head office is in Gurgaon, Haryana. They also play a very important role in promoting agricultural products. Then have National Commodity Exchange, similar to this, not playing very important role. And India, the commodity marketing future, and India is the largest consumer in the world, and we are the largest producer of wheat, rice in the world, and if all these products come to the market, our market size will be very high. And also the hub of valued product like services, food processing is emerging in the Indian market, and a new class of commodities, commodity traders and value investors coming in the market. Benefits of derivative marketing, I told you that if you sell in the spot market, you have to face lot of risk, price risk and production risk. To avoid that, you trade in the future market. It is beneficial both for the consumers as well as the farmers, and marketing uncertainties are mitigated. But in conclusion, what we can say is majority of the Indian investors are not aware of organized commodity market. Government is making all effort to see that agriculture commodities are traded in the market, but unlike financial market today, around 60% of the middle class families are investing money in the financial market, but their investment is very less in the commodity market. That is mainly because maybe lack of information, lack of interest, or maybe because they earn more money in the financial market, they lose money more in the financial market also. And many a times community market is not available in online just like in financial market. So because of that also, the our Indian investors are not investing much money in that. And in the near future, along with the government effort, NGOs should come forward to educate the people. Now India is such a diversified vast country. Having an exchange in Mumbai, Delhi will not serve the people in the rest of the country. In spite of having IT revolution, in spite of having a network of the agencies like we have agriculture universities spreading a lot of news, but again the role is limited. Agriculture universities are supposed to educate, train people in commodity marketing, educate people in the market forecasting, but that role is very limited. In that case, NGOs, partnering institution, the government agencies are partnering with NGOs to spread the news, to educate farmers, to train the farmers to take part in the commodity market. If the commodity market expands the volume of trade expands, then automatically GDP will be very high. Now the Indian rupee value is going down. Because of that, petrol is becoming very costly. When petrol becomes costly again, and retail products again becomes costly, again it have a impact on the Indian rupee value. So to avoid this, the goods has to be traded in the organized market. It will have a great contribution to the development of GDP, and will have prosperity everywhere. That is the role of commodity market in the Indian economy. This in it provided you a brief understanding about what is commodity exchange market, what are different types of market that are in India, and what is the benefit if you trade in the commodity exchange. Thank you very much.